spank you.
Would you really spank me, Marilla?
If you don't be still when you're told.
I bet you couldn't keep still when you were only as old as me.
I certainly did if I was told to.
That's because you was a girl. You was a girl once, wasn't you?
I was.
Well, Dora's a girl too, and I just made all girls me lightening up.
Stop it!
Davy, behave yourself.
Dora, why don't you come with me and I'll help you to bed? I think Davy needs to be alone with Marilla.
How can you be such a naughty boy with your poor mother just recently laid in her grave?
But she was glad to die. She told me she was awful tired of being sick. We had a long talk the night before she died.
I'm glad, Davy, I really am. What else did your mother say?
To be nice to you and Aunt, and to be kind to Dora, and to stand up for her.
You call pulling her hair being kind to her?
Well, I ain't gonna let nobody else pull her hair.
And while we're discussing manners, I want you to be more polite at the supper table.
But I'm usually so hungry I ain't got time to eat politely.
And when you ask for another piece of cake, you must say thank you like a gentleman.
But I can't be a gentleman if I go out.
Oh, yes, you can. And gentlemen never tease girls or pull their hair.
Boy, gentlemen don't have much fun, that's a fact. There ain't gonna be one till I grow up.
Come on, Davy. Dora's in bed. It's your turn. I will help you wash your face.
But Marilla washed it yesterday. And Mrs. Wiggins washed it the day of the funeral. Twice a week is plenty enough.
I'm afraid not.
I guess Paul Irving washes his face every day.
I suspect he does. And probably all by himself.
I hate Paul Irving.
You don't even know him.
Yeah, I feel like I do the way you talk about him all the time.
I talk about all my pupils.
But him the most, since I guess he's perfect.
Nobody's perfect, not even Paul Irving.
You make him sound pretty close to it. Well, if Paul Irving washes his face every day, I will too. And by myself.